In this video, you will learn how to remotely access a Windows computer from another Windows computer without opening any ports to the internet. Before you begin, you will need to create a remote.it account at the remote.it website, install the remote.it desktop app on both Windows devices, and both devices must be on, awake, and connected to their respective networks. If you need help with any of this, please refer to the information in the description box below. The methods presented in this tutorial can only be used if the target Windows computer supports remote desktop. This includes additions such as Windows 10 Pro and Enterprise. Instructions on how to enable remote desktop on Windows 10 Home can be found in the description box below. In the case that your target Windows device does not support remote desktop, you will need to use another remote connection software such as VNC. In order to remotely access a Windows device, you will need to set the RDP remote access permissions on the device you would like to connect to. In this case, the computer I want to connect to is running on Windows 10 Pro. Start by opening the control panel. Click on System and Security. Find System and click on Allow Remote Access. This System Properties dialog will appear. Under Remote Desktop, select Allow Remote Connection to this computer. This dialog will appear if your computer is set to go to sleep while not in use. Your computer must be awake to connect to it remotely, so to change this setting, click on Power Options. This dialog will appear. Next to Balanced, click Change Plan Settings. Under the Put the Computer to Sleep drop-down menu, select Never. Then click Save Changes. Then go back to this dialog and select OK. Confirm this box is checked, so the computer will only allow connections from authenticated computers. Then click the OK button to save these changes. RDP has now been enabled on the device. To ensure RDP is working properly, before connecting remotely, we recommend first checking that you can connect from another device over your local network. If you are unsure of how to do this, please check out the link in the description box below. Open the remote.it desktop app on the target device and sign into your remote.it account. The Settings tab should be open, but if not, just click on it. Click on Setup Remote Access. You will be brought to this menu. By default, the device in your remote.it account will be given the same name as your PC, but if you would like to change it, you can do so now. I'm just going to use the default. Under Services, you will see these four Quick Add options. Some of the Quick Add services will already be checked. Technically, you can actually check this box next to MSWB2 Server because that is the type of service you will be connecting with. But for the purposes of this tutorial, I will be manually adding a service later, so I will be unchecking all of these services. Then click the blue Register button. This confirmation dialog will appear. Click Yes to grant permission for the desktop application to run. When the green check mark appears, the registration process for the device is complete. After registering the device, in order to make a connection to it, you need to add an RDP service. To do this, go back to the Settings tab and click on the name of your device. Then, under Services, click Add Manually. Enter a service name here. I'm using Windows to Windows, since I will be using this service to connect from another Windows computer to this Windows computer. Then, under Type, select RDP from the drop-down menu. Port 3389 will be selected by default. This is the port that Windows automatically assigns to RDP, so it should not be changed. Note that adding the service is not opening this port to the internet. It will only be accessible from your remote.it account. This host address should also be left as the default. Click the checkmark to save the service. This confirmation dialog will appear. Click Yes to grant permission for the command line interface or CLI application to run. These boxes will turn gray, indicating that the service was successfully added. Then go to the Devices tab in the bottom menu. The device you just registered will now be displayed. This gray icon means that the device is not online yet. Note that it may take a couple minutes for the device and the service you just registered to come online. If they have not come online after a few minutes, refresh the page. When the device is online, this green checkmark will appear. If you click on the device, you can also see the RDP service you just registered. Now you're ready to connect remotely. Now, from a different Windows device, open the Remote.it desktop app. Log in with the same Remote.it credentials you used earlier. Then click the Sign In button. After a few minutes, the device you just registered will appear under the Devices tab. Click on the device. You will see the RDP service you registered. Then click the green Connect button next to the service. Once you've connected, the Connect button will turn into a blue Disconnect button. This is the address you will use to connect to your device. This is a localhost address, meaning that by using it, you will be directly connecting to your target Windows device. This is also known as a peer-to-peer connection. For more information about peer-to-peer connections, check the information in the description box below. Click on this clipboard icon to copy this address. Then open the RDP client application. It is called Remote Desktop Connection. And paste the address here. Click the Connect button. Enter the username and password of your target Windows computer. Then press OK. This confirmation dialog will appear. Click Yes. The desktop of your target Windows machine will appear. You are now remotely connected and can use your Windows computer as usual. To stop the connection, first close the RDP client application. This confirmation dialog will appear. Click OK. Open the Remote.it desktop app. Then you can either go to the Devices tab and click on the Disconnect button next to the service you would like to stop, or you can go to the Connections tab in the bottom menu and click the Disconnect button next to the service you would like to stop. When the Disconnect button turns green, the connection has been terminated. For additional information, visit our website or contact support at Remote.it. Thanks for watching.